I have something for you to do.
What's that?
I want you to write down everything that you can think of that he's done wrong.
Miss Clara, if I did that, I'd be writing a long time.
Well, then just write down the highlights. And I'll be back to check on you in a little while. Oh, that's almost 3 pages.
And I could write more, but you'll get the gist of it when you read it.
Actually, I'm not gonna read it. My question to you is this. In light of all these wrongs, does God still love Tony?
We both know he does.
Do you?
Now, Miss Clara, you're meddling. There's love in my heart for Tony, but it's just buried under a lot of frustration.
So he needs grace.
Grace? I don't know that he deserves grace.
Do you deserve grace?
Miss Clara, you have a habit of backing me up in a corner and making me squirm.
I felt the same way. But the question still remains, do you deserve grace? The Bible says that no one is righteous, not even one. For we have all sinned. So really none of us deserve grace. But we all still want God's forgiveness. Elizabeth, it comes down to this. Jesus shed his blood on the cross. He died for you, even when you did not deserve it. And he rose from the grave and offers forgiveness and salvation for anyone who turns to him.
Yes.
But the Bible also says that we can't ask him to forgive us while refusing to forgive us.
Ha!
I know, Miss Clara. But that's just so hard to do.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. But that's where grace comes in. He gives us grace, and he helps us to give it to others, even when they don't deserve it. We all deserve judgment. And that is what a holy God gives us when we don't repent and believe in his son. I had to forgive Leo for some things. And it wasn't easy, but it freed me. Elizabeth, there's not room for you and God on the throne of your heart. It's either him or it's you. You need to step down. Now, if you want victory, you're going to have to first surrender.
Yes.
Miss Clara, do I just back off? And choose to forgive and then just let him walk all over me?
God is a good defense attorney. Trust it to him. And then you can turn your focus to the real enemy.
The real enemy?
The one that wants to remain hidden. The one that wants to distract you and deceive you and divide you from the Lord and your husband. You see, that's how it works. Satan comes to steal, kill, and destroy.
Ego.
And he is stealing your joy. He is killing your faith. And he's trying to destroy your family. If I were you, I would get my heart right with God. And you need to do your fighting in prayer. And you need to kick the real enemy out of your home with the word of God. It's time for you to fight, Elizabeth. It's time for you to fight for your marriage. It's time for you to fight the real enemy. It's time for you to take off the gloves and do it. You pray, but scripture does say to go into your inner room and pray in secret. And your heavenly Father, who sees what's done in secret, will reward you. Now get rid of any distractions and focus your heart and mind on him. Acknowledge that he is God and that you desperately need him. Now be grateful for your blessings, but lift your needs and requests to him. If you've got something to confess, then confess it. Ask him for forgiveness. Then choose to believe him when he says that he loves you and will take care of you. Then pray for the heart of your husband, your daughter, and anyone else that the Lord brings to your mind. And don't rush it. You take your time, and then you listen.